Hi YouTube world, welcome back to my channel and welcome if you're new here. So today, as the video suggests, I want to talk about my favorite audiobooks of this year at least. So I read a lot of books over the course of the year. Like so far, according to my Goodreads, I've read 26 books. I'll share a screenshot of my Goodreads post here. And out of those 26 books, I've listened to a good number of audiobooks this year. And according to my profile on Audible, so I use Audible for my audiobooks. According to Audible, I've listened to 15 books on the platform. So out of these 15, there are books that have been outstanding and there are books that have been much better than others and I've had a better listening experience. And these are the books that I want to talk about in this video. So let's get into it. So number one on the list, I would say Greenlight by Matthew McConaughey just is a highlight. I'll keep a copy of the book here so that you can go look for it if you want. So Greenlight by Matthew McConaughey is, the audio version is the best because I think Matthew's voice has this thing where he just does things. So he has the best voice and then he's reading his own book. So imagine his voice reading his book. I mean, guys, you just won't get the match, but I think it's the best match. Also because his book is kind of light, so it felt like fire time story time, you know? It was just so good. It felt casual and like inspiring and it felt like everything for real. So the book Greenlight is about, like, it's literally his biography. So it's about his life, like the things he's been through, the things he has learned and all of that. So it's just so good. Like if you have not read Greenlight by Matthew McConaughey, I would highly recommend that you go for the audiobook version because you're gonna have a good time. You're gonna have the best time, actually, the best time. So that's number one in my list. The number two spot goes to Daisy Jones and the Six. I'll add the cover here again. Daisy Jones and the Six is a book about Daisy Jones and the Six. So they were a band back in the days. And so this book is a story about like how they became a band, because before they were a band, Daisy Jones were a separate artist and the Six were separate group, like how they became a single thing, how they worked together, the dynamics of them working together, because Daisy Jones was involved with one of the key singers of the Six, the band, and the guy was married and it was a whole fiasco. So I actually listened to this book a while ago, so I don't remember their names well, apart from Daisy Jones, because she's like the highlight and she's this kind of character like you can't forget about. You know those people that you will never forget about them no matter what you try, because they kind of like live their lives in their own terms, which makes them unique and makes them stand out. So their stories are hard to forget. So that was Daisy Jones. And honestly, if I had to say anything about Daisy Jones, I would say I love her. And I really hope that she has found the right place for herself in her life. And I hope she went on and did the best for herself after the whole book thing was done. But Daisy Jones and the Six was a good book. And generally, I do like the Daisy Jones of the world. You know, I think there are people who have these kind of traits where they just like be like, fuck the world, I'm gonna do what I want to do. I really admire that. I really admire that character. So to all the Daisy Jones out there, I salute you. So that book will go number two on my favorite audiobooks. My third favorite audiobook, this is a honorable mention, it's A Little Life, bruh. I did enjoy this book so much, you know, like I even had to like, I remember this one time I went to the gym and then I was listening to the book. I was somewhere between my first workout set and I was like, you know what, how this story is going to end is much more important than this workout that I'm having. And then I just went outside the gym and I went by the pool, because yeah, so there was a pool outside our gym and I went by the pool and I just sit there and listen to the book for my whole time, like until the sunset, because that's when I was expected to leave the gym. So I just canceled my session just because I was like, I need to know how this book is going, like it was that good. And I think A Little Life, if you've ever seen the book itself, it's a bit thick. So I think if you read the physical book, I'm not sure how I managed to reach the physical book, because I myself have a fear for thick books. Like, I'm kind of like afraid of thick books. So I'm not sure if I would have been able to read that book through if I was reading the physical book, but the audiobook made it seamless. And the fact that each character had their own, I feel like the people who read the audiobook kind of like captured the sounds correctly on how you're supposed to feel about the character and all of that. So that just like added to the feel of the book. Like, it was a 10 out of 10. It was a plus. So I really liked A Little Life, the audiobook version. And if you have not read the book yet, or if maybe you've been reading the physical book and you're somewhat stuck just because you're reading the physical book, I would highly recommend that you go for the audio version. Like, it's smooth, it's the smoothest. And then it feels so much like a story time. But you know, because the story itself in A Little Life is a little life, like everything, like it's giving all the emotions that you are supposed to get. So just like hearing them, I think like if I read the book, I would not have enjoyed it as much as the fact that I listened to it. I don't know if you get it. If you've listened to A Little Life, you get what I'm saying. But if you have not, you're missing out. So that's number three, and that's a honorable mention, because I really did love this book. And it's interesting that I did love this book because the story is kind of like heartbreaking. Like, the story is not fun. It's heartbreaking, but I think that book made me cry a number of times, like crying, which is why if anyone asks me about A Little Life, I'll say like, don't read it in public, because you're definitely gonna cry somewhere along the way. You're gonna cry. It's just a given, because the book is giving all the emotions that you're supposed to get. Like, I can't say enough about A Little Life. But so that would be number three for my favorite audiobooks that I've listened to this year. Number four would be Beach Read by Emir Henry. Beach Read, this is a bit light. So it was more of like, it's just what the title suggests. It's just like a beach read. It's so light, it's so easy. It's just like lightheaded. But I think I did love the audiobook because I kind of like small town romance kind of books. And this is just it. This is more of like a story. This is more of like a small town romance kind of book. So I did love it for that. But I liked it the most. I liked the audio book the most, because I think if I'd read the physical book, I would not get Augusta's feelings. Because in some places I found like what he was saying, like what the words were saying and his sound kind of like were not matching. So I think from the sound, then you can get that he's pissed. But from the words, he was more like, I don't know if you're getting it. You know, like sometimes someone could say something that is not bad, no good, but the tone of the sound that they're using is what will help you determine if this person is pissed, they're mad or whatever. So I think with the character Augustus, he was more like that. Like, most, his character was more like somewhere in the middle. You never know what he's actually saying. So I think the fact that I listened to the book, I kind of like had to get the emotions even more, because I think the sounding also like kind of helps you understanding what emotion are they like trying to display here, you know. So that goes up number four of my favorite audiobooks that I've listened to this year. And number five would go to this. So there is this short story that I listened to early on this year, I think back in January or February. So it's an audiobook special and it's called Little Pa. It's a sweet short story. So Little Pa is a story about this, I think it was a guy from Senegal who moves to France. So it's a whole story about family dimensions, I would say. So also in its way, it's also kind of like heartbreaking, but not like very heartbreaking. But I liked mostly the storytelling style of it and the way that a lot was said in such a short time, you know, like he managed to say like a lot of things in such a small space while displaying like all the emotions and allowing the readers to like feel everything in it. So yeah, that will be number five of the favorite audiobooks that I've listened to this year. So that's it. So yeah, I think that's it for this video. As I mentioned, I did listen to a total of 15 books this year on Audible, and I have a bit more books that I want to listen to. I guess I'll get them whenever I get time. But out of those 15 that I've listened to through Audible, these 5 outdid themselves. Like, the audio was just next level, and it was like a different whole reading experience. So these are my 5 favorite audiobooks that I've listened to this year. Oh, one more thing, by the way. Also, something else that I did like about Daisy Jones and the Six is the fact that it felt so much like a podcast recording, if it makes sense, because the way it's written, it's like every person in the story tells their part, and then the other person will also tell their part. So it was more like they're having a conversation, you know. So it was so cute. All right, guys, thank you for watching to the very end. I hope you join me by subscribing and returning to watch some other videos that I'll be posting soon. Thank you for staying to the very end, and I'm looking forward to seeing you again. Adios.